Hi there, your computer friend Connie here. Today we're going to look at OneNote and the pens in the drawing toolbar. So come with me as I show you what they're all about. So let's start by discovering what pens there are available to you, how they work, what you can do with them. So if we go to the draw toolbar, you'll notice that the draw toolbar area with the pens starts with an eraser. Always handy to get yourself out of trouble. We'll look at that in a few minutes. And then we have all these wonderfully colored pens, plus a couple of highlighters, and at the end here is a couple of pencils. And right beside that is the plus sign that'll actually let you add more pens. But before we do that, let's just investigate these a little bit, and then we'll look at how we can make changes to our pens and what we can do with them. So let's start by testing out these pens. I'm gonna pick the blue pen from the pen toolbar and just immediately start drawing on my page. Now I'm using my computer, my mouse actually attached to my computer, but I certainly could be using a tablet and an actual pen that works on a tablet or an iPad or something of that nature. And that of course will work as well. Just to continue, let's look at another pen. So I'm gonna pick the green one here and let's look at this multicolored pen, rainbow one. Okay, and then we have the highlighters. So highlighters are best used to highlight information. So usually that means you're highlighting some text. I got a couple of different highlighters here. You might want different colors, and I'll show you how to get those in a minute. But before we change anything, let's just investigate these pencils. So we have the blue pencil and the pink pencil. So the pencil looks a little bit different than the pen. Let's go to this purple one. Okay, so those are all the pens and pencils and highlighters that we have. Quite a bit of drawing that probably needs to be erased at this point. So if I just click directly on the eraser, I have an icon that looks like an eraser, and all I have to do is kind of swoop down over any drawing that I've made and it'll erase the entire drawing. I don't have to follow the drawing. So what I mean by that is just watch as I kind of move this eraser down. So it got rid of the entire drawing. So it's looking at it for a continuous stroke. So the continuous drawing that I made. If I stopped somewhere in it, it won't. So obviously it's only doing one at a time. I can certainly go like this and they're all gone. Cool. So just to go a little bit further on what I mean here, I'm gonna draw a picture that isn't continuous, right? Like all the lines don't meet up so that you can see how the eraser affects that. House is looking a little bit scary there. Okay, quick picture using my mouse, wasn't using a pen, so that makes it even more fun. But now let's try the eraser again. With that one stroke of the eraser, it didn't get rid of the entire house because of where I put the eraser. It got rid of a continuous line though. So you can see how all of these other parts of the house are not necessarily continuous. So I just wanna show you that piece. So obviously this is continuous. That's one piece, that's a piece. Let's see what it does here. Yeah, so it sees some of these separate. Now you could of course just use the eraser all the way across the house to get rid of it all, but I want you to understand what it's doing. And so the reason it's doing this is because this eraser is referred to as the stroke eraser, getting rid of the actual stroke of the pen. So let's just use the menu. So there's a little arrow beside the eraser. There's a menu available there, and you'll see that the menu is set to stroke eraser. You have other choices though. You can say, well, you know what? I don't want that eraser. I want a different kind of eraser. So we've got small, medium, and large to choose from. Let's check out some of these erasers. If I choose the small eraser, now my mouse changes to this tiny little box that is giving me the size of the eraser. And if I start with this red line here, you see I have to, like if I go like this, like I was doing with the other eraser, it's not getting rid of the whole thing. I do have to trace it now. So it is a bit more precise, right? If I'm trying to erase something just a little bit, maybe I'm trying to make an E out of this thing here. Oh, maybe went too far. So that then it lets me be a bit more precise. Let's go get a bigger eraser. Let's get that large eraser. And now I have a much bigger box. And so if I use it, it's getting rid of the lines as well. So these erasers only get rid of drawings. So you notice it's not getting rid of any of my text, right? Just getting rid of the drawings. So that's really good to know. Now, whatever eraser you use last, it's going to remember that for the future. So if you pick the eraser again, it's going to remember the last eraser, give it to you to use, or you can pick from that drop-down menu. So now that we've discovered the drop-down menu on the eraser, let's discover the drop-down menus that are available to you in the pens. I'm going to go to the first pen here, the black one. And to the right of it at the bottom is that little arrow. And in the menu here, it's showing me the size of pen that I can use. So the point size, right? And so if I pick any of these dots, I'm changing the size of my pen. And the minus and the plus are to help me make those changes. It's just really saying increase the thickness of my pen or decrease the thickness of my pen. And then right underneath it, I have all these wonderful colors, even some cool little designs. I also have the ability to go to more colors. And more colors really gives us a huge spectrum of colors to choose from. So there's no reason why you shouldn't have your favorite color available to you somewhere on the spectrum. Let's say I want to choose maybe a brown. So now my pen's changed from a black to a brown. We also have in this pen menu the ability to delete. So delete would mean that I'm deleting the pen from my toolbar. So do you want to delete the pen from your toolbar? Do you have too many pens on your toolbar? Maybe you have the wrong colors. So you can see here with this menu, you have the ability to choose the thickness of that pen stroke. You can choose the colors, your favorite colors, and you can have as many pens on your toolbar as you want, sort of like how many pens do I want in my pencil case? And if you don't need some of the pens, you can certainly delete them. If you delete a pen, so let's go about deleting this one, it disappears, but you can use the plus sign here to add back that pen. In fact, when you hit the plus sign, notice that we have the ability to add in a pencil, so I can choose a pencil if I want, and a particular color pencil. If I hit the plus sign again, I can choose a pen. And again, I can choose what color pen. Which color don't I have? And if I hit the plus sign again, I can choose a highlighter. So I have a couple of highlighters already, but I don't have a pink one. And again, with the highlighter, just like with the pen, I can choose the thickness of that. So one other thing you can do with this toolbar is that you can rearrange your pens in whatever order you want. So I'm going to move my highlighter with my highlighters and my pen over here with my pens, so I have them all in order. Now let's just do a little bit more experimenting with our pens on our page. So let's use the pens to add some more color to this page and to highlight information, maybe put circles around stuff as well. So I'll just go about doing a few things here. I'll use my blue pen and maybe we'll put a square around some stuff here, not necessarily very straight. My red pen. And my orange pen. Now keep in mind, when you're in pen mode, everything you do is going to be based on that fact that you have a pen. So if you click somewhere, you're leaving little pen marks on the page. So be careful of that. That's where the eraser comes in handy, so you can erase those pen marks, right? You also have an undo, so if you just did it, yeah, you can definitely undo it. But if it was something that was put on the page earlier, you may not have an opportunity to undo it. So that's why it's good to know about that eraser as well. So now that I have the eraser, I'm on eraser mode. So I need to change it back to pen mode. If I don't want to be drawing anymore at all, I can go back to selecting my information or to typing text. And to do that, I kind of go over to the left of my draw menu or toolbar, and I choose this little A with the arrow and the cursor in it, and that will get me back into typing mode or selection mode. So see how I have a regular cursor, so I can, let's just type something. I can type, and I can select things. So if I click on text, I'm selecting text. If I click on the drawing, I'm selecting the drawing. So I just wanted to show you one more example of how we can use the drawings to help us. So maybe there's an image or some kind of picture you've put on your page and you want to point to something and make some notes about it. So easy to do when you have those pens available to you. So just experiment, see what you can make of it. And remember, you have your eraser if you want to get out of trouble. You have undo if you just did it and you want to get out of it quickly. And you, of course, have the lasso if you want to fix a whole bunch of stuff all at once. So have some fun drawing. Thanks for watching. Talk to you again. Bye-bye.